next two stories that were written by Brian Fredwarne MacGregor in 2021. No parts, whole or otherwise, are to be copied, duplicated, reproduced or transmitted without prior written consent under copyright Brian Fredwarne MacGregor 2021. Although these stories are fictional, please consider whether or not they would be suitable before continuing, as both have themes running throughout with various emotional elements as part of their act. A Pattern with Tears by Brian Fredwarne MacGregor 2021. She herself, Bessie, had knitted for charity all her life and enjoyed it too. However, she was now at the age where she had decided to retire as such from everything and lead a wholly quiet life as such, even from her charity, which she loved, as she realised she was becoming frailer more so as time passed. Her favourite was jumpers, which are often considered the knitter's favourite, and hers too, she remarked rather gently. She had worked at the same charity all her life, which had seen change over the years, including the shop too, which had more makeovers than any of the models in the window. She knitted exclusively for the charity since she was very young, as she said herself, and sold all of her produce there since year dot. As it turned out, she had knitted her last, which turned out to be the 10,000th, in over 50 years exactly today, which is when she finished that very last one. She had one unusual request at the last second, which she agreed to immediately, as she was asked to repair a jumper, a very old one, made by an expert, although they were much younger when it was made. Naturally, Bessie was flattered to be repairing a jumper for an expert who had knitted it many moons ago. At any rate, Bessie finished her jumper, that 10,000th one, rather quickly. I mean, she had been doing this a while and excelled at it. She handed over the jumper with a tear in her eye, realising it was her last, which she remarked rather sadly. Bessie then adds, nothing could make this day more special than this award for serving the shop 50 years. She was then reminded she wasn't done yet, so don't get comfy, as everyone around her laughed rather loudly. Bessie then says, yes, I know, I have the repair job to be done now. Okay, I will do it just now. At which point, she was handed a jumper, which she immediately took a fancy to. Bessie then says, this is beautiful, I will repair this right away. In fact, just now. She checks the jumper over and over and says, oh my, there's a mistake. There's no holes or tears in this at all. It's the wrong one. The staff then adds, check the label. You hadn't made sure that's intact. Bessie then says, oh yes, of course, silly me. She checks the label, then near enough faints. Bessie adds, it's one of mine. The staff then adds, yes, we know. It's the first one you ever knitted for us 50 years ago. It's never been worn and it's brand new. We found it in the loft sealed fresh as fresh can be under the insulation, whilst we were fixing the insulation itself up there. Bessie, well, she looked away, teary-eyed, before saying, nothing will ever compare to this moment. And she put the jumper on, then sniffs with tears dripping off her chin, before finally adding, it even fits me still. Thank you, thank you. Every thank you after that, they became progressively quieter. Thank you. The end of story one of two. A Pattern with Tears by Brian Fredwarne MacGregor, 2021. Story 2 of 2. The Real Operator by Brian Fredwarne MacGregor, 2021. He, Mitch, was a camera reel operator in an independent chain of cinemas. It could be said he was a film buff of sorts, as he truly loved his movies, especially the very early ones, which he truly loved, and he had a large collection of films, very mixed in type at home, although he was never there because the best flicks were at work, he joked. He loved to work, although never done any as such, and laughed that he would stay here at work if he really could. Mitch often joked he would either make or make it into a classic film one day, which had other staff roaring with laughter. The benefit was he got to see every film he played at work, as obviously he had to make sure they ran smoothly for the paying customers. He had seen many zany films over the years, but nothing captured his enthusiasm as much as films which were sealed officially and never opened, since their creation and sealing itself was way back when in some occasions. He often laughed and said he would love to capture his life in film, but it would be quite boring, he reckoned. Not much entertainment in that, he joked. The last day before his holidays came, he joked, "I'm taking time off to watch some movies." The day ended and his boss said, "Seeing how you're taking time off to relax, you can do something useful," to which Mitch groaned, before then asking, "What?" The boss handed him a sealed container, which immediately piqued Mitch's attention. At this point, Mitch then chuckled, "Oh well, don't mind if I do check the quality, and of course, I will make sure the film is complete. That will make me quite happy." Mitch was quite excited, and once home, he checked the film, which he said was amazing. However, the characters were talking to someone on the film who he couldn't see. It's almost like they were there, but were not, if you know what I mean, he then said to himself. It was a smashing film, he remarked. In fact, it's the best I've ever seen. At this point, he added, "I wish it was complete though, as I was happy watching it all the way through." He got comfy on his couch before abruptly falling asleep after he had been at work all day and simply conked out at the very end of this movie, but not before writing on the container, "Checked and fabulous," then signed it. Several weeks passed and Ted, Mitch's boss, was handed the container, which apparently was handed in whilst his effects were collected, that of Mitch's, from his office. Ted checked the container and written in apparently what he noticed as Mitch's writing was some notes for his attention. Mitch had said the film is complete and the ending was fabulous. "I couldn't have asked for anything better." Ted just smiled. He then sealed the container and placed it away behind a stack of newer ones in the era marked 1900. Ted then remarked, "Well, Mitch, you've probably had the best role in this picture house." He adds a little teary-eyed, in that Mitch wouldn't be coming back, before then walking off down the corridor. Ted later realised Mitch really did. And after watching the movie, it was rediscovered, then sold for an undisclosed high value sum at auction. However, the main character to this day was never credited, although Ted remembers them well.